Hi everyone, welcome to Linkin Park Zoo. We are so glad you're here. On today's Stay Tuned to the Zoo, we are going to take a closer and quieter look at animals who have certain behaviors, adaptations, or even build special homes in the winter. You'll get a chance to learn more about how some species get cozy in the cold. It is winter here in Chicago and it is pretty chilly outside, which is a perfect time to highlight some of our winter-ready species, many of whom live right here in Prisker Family Children's Zoo. Some of these species may be tricky to spot this time of year, and that's because each of them has a different tactic to protect them from extremely low temperatures. This is all part of their incredible species adaptation to survive when there may be scarce resources out in their natural habitats. Bears are an excellent place to start because they hibernate in the winter. This is a well-known tactic, but first, what is hibernation? Hibernation is a period of time when an animal or plant is in a dormant or inactive state. Most of the time, this is characterized by things like low body temperature, slow breathing and heart rate, or a low metabolic rate. There is a wide spectrum of different levels of hibernation, from the deep, true sleeping hibernation, all the way up to daily shallow hibernation, sometimes referred to as torpor. Different species are going to experience different levels of hibernation, from bats to woodchucks to bear species. Here at Linkin Park Zoo, there are two species of bears, the American black bear and the polar bear. In northern parts of their region, in North America, American black bears undergo a natural annual period of hibernation, lasting up to 7 months. Wow, that's a long time. And during this hibernation for the entire period, they are going to stay in their dens, which are usually dug in the snow or the earth. They're going to live off of stored fat in their body and reduce way down their heart rate and body temperature to conserve energy. In the southern parts of their region, in North America, American black bears may spend much less time hibernating or not hibernate at all. Food and resource availability is a critical factor to determine how active these bears may remain throughout the year. When they're not hibernating, black bears are solitary animals. They spend a lot of time alone in their habitat, moving slowly about their range, searching for foods like fruits and roots. They're also incredibly good swimmers and quite capable of climbing trees. Interestingly, the other species of bear who live here at Linkin Park Zoo, the polar bear, do things a little bit differently. In fact, polar bears do not really hibernate at all. Pregnant females do something called denning. This can be thought of like a light hibernation, but not quite like that true deep sleep hibernation that we often see in rodents and bats. If the female does have cubs, this allows her to use that light hibernation to use a minimum amount of her energy while continuing to care for her young. Otherwise, polar bears are awake and moving about their habitat all year round. Next up on our list of winter-ready species may surprise you, turtles. While turtles are not true hibernators, they do have a special name for their adaptations that allow them to survive when temperatures get particularly low. Hibernation in cold-blooded or ectothermic species is called brumation. Brumation is a period of dormancy or inactivity exhibited in reptiles when particularly low temperatures come around or throughout the winter months. Many temperate climate turtles brumate during the winter. Because they spend so much of their time near the water, it's no surprise that turtles also brumate near or underwater. That's right, underwater. Turtles do have lungs and need to breathe air, which is why they need an incredibly special adaptation to allow them to stay in that state of brumation underwater for incredibly long amounts of time. As the water moves slowly across their body, systems of blood vessels, kind of like a net or a spider web under their skin, is going to absorb small amounts of oxygen, which is all they need to survive during this time. And what part of their body has the most blood vessels? Their butts. That's right, turtles survive this critically important brumation period during the winter months by breathing through their butts. Nature is wild. Not all species hibernate or brumate. Some species even prepare for winter by building specialized homes. Beavers do this in the creation of lodges and dams. American beavers are experts at manipulating their environment. With robust teeth that are long and sharp, they're able to take down relatively large trees, which are used to construct their dams and lodges. They need pretty large spaces for their lodges, and if one is not available, that's when they build their dams to stop the water flow and create the space for themselves that they need. Constructed of sticks and mud, lodges are large. In fact, the main room of a lodge can be upwards of 3 feet tall and 4 to 5 feet wide. That means I could probably sit down with my head up and my feet out straight right in the middle of a beaver lodge. These are often only accessible from underwater, which makes easy entrance for beavers, but protects them from predators on the land. These same lodges are used by beaver families year after year, and oftentimes they will cache or store branches and logs to use for food during winter months when food resources may be scarce. Of course, caring for species is a year-round responsibility, hot or cold, sunny or snowy. Because some species do change their activity levels, diet preferences, or behaviors depending on the season, their care also needs to reflect that. The simplest way that we can describe the seasonal change of their care is that we provide everything that each species needs to exhibit their natural behaviors depending on the time of year. Using the bear as an example, they may need a private, quiet space with additional bedding materials and little disturbance. Some species require more or less of their diet, but don't worry, the animals always have access to fresh food and water provided by their caretakers. Being able to provide so that these species can exhibit their natural behaviors is how care continues even in the cold. Thank you so much for joining us to learn a little bit more about how some animals get cozy in the cold, including bears and hibernation, turtles and brumation, and beavers building lodges and dams. We hope you're staying warm and cozy in your own habitat.
Today we learned all about animals that tuck away for the winter and the homes and shelters that they make. Now let's make a few homes and shelters of our own out of some materials that we can find around the house. You can make anything you want, a den, a burrow, or anything else that we learned about today. First, go gather some supplies from around the house. I've gathered some pillows, blankets, sheets, and even a little bit of rope in case I decide to tie some walls up on one of my shelters. So the first type of shelter I'm gonna make is a nest. Lots of animals make nests, and some of my favorite animals, birds, make all different kinds of nests. And they do it with just their beak and their mouth, which I think is really amazing. I think it would be really hard for me to weave a nest with just my feet and my mouth. Fortunately, we have hands. So to start off my nest, I'm gonna take a blanket and make it into sort of a circle on the floor here. And I'm gonna use a couple blankets, maybe a sheet. And now I think I'm gonna put a couple pillows in here because I want it to be a little more comfy. What do you think? Am I done? I think I'm ready to take a nap. So we just built our nest. What do you think we should build next? I think I'm gonna build a den. I set these two chairs up so that I can use these as the walls to my den. I think I'm gonna use one of these blankets to make sort of the roof and the backside. Now I'm gonna put a few things inside my den to make it a little more comfy. I'm gonna use this pillow, maybe a couple of blankets. What do you think? Does it look ready for me to take a nap? I think I could use this until the next warm winter day comes along.
What is this?
And then you're inside the horse.
We're building a tent. So.
Thanks for joining me today and stay tuned to the zoo. Good night.